Hello everybody, I'm Tejasvi Mukherjee. Since today's Women's Day, I was thinking of making something special for my mom. I think I'm gonna go to ginger garlic basa fish with mashed potatoes and sauteed vegetables. It is still healthy, light and delicious. Don't you think it will be right? The ingredients for marination will be basa fish, a bawal, turmeric powder, chili powder, ginger garlic paste, cloves of garlic, and rock salt. First, I'm going to put a few fishes into the bowl. Next, I'm going to add some turmeric. Sprinkle it over the fish. I think I'll need a little bit more. Next, add some spoons of garlic, chili powder, now a bit of garlic paste. On the silver side, I am using a wooden spoon. Now I'm going to take 3 to 4 cloves of garlic. I can use 3. And crush it with this. As you can see, it's getting crushed. So crush it nicely and smoothly until it becomes almost like paste. And then I will put this into this and put rock salt. So this makes this process of now you can see I have added everything and now I'm gonna nicely mix it. As you can see, it needs to be mixed nicely for the process of marination to get over. So I'm gonna mix it for some time so that the smell of the fish goes away. And I get the nice scented new fish with a good taste. I can literally smell it. It's yummy. Now, I'm going to leave this for 10 minutes for it to soak in all the masala and make it more delicious. While the fish is getting marinated, I would like to prepare the potatoes for it to be mashed. So first, for my requirements, I will take 3 potatoes, a cooker, and a jug of water. Inside the cooker, I will put the 3 potatoes and fill it till the top of the potato, like this. So now you can see this potato has been filled. This one is also being filled. And now I'm going to close the cooker. So now I'm going to take the cooker on the cooktop and boil it till I get 3 whistles so that I know it's perfectly boiled. I'm gonna leave it for 3 whistles and going and take my marinated fish. Since it's been 10 minutes are over.
While the potato is boiling, the fish is getting marinated, I am going to focus on cutting the vegetables for the saute. So first I'm gonna cut the spring onions. I've washed them nicely and I've taken 3 of them, but you could take more if you like. So if there's skin, you can remove it. Now I'm gonna cut it. And yes, you need to do fine cutting for it if you want a perfect saute. Mine is very fine, and if you want a perfect saute, you could do this too. These 3 are my favorite vegetables, so that's why I'm doing. Whatever leftover stem you can not, if you want, you cannot use it. Or you can. So I am not using mine. See how fine I have cut it. So I have a little more left. This is my spring onion mixture. Now I am going to, if I would like, I could grow these, but now I'm going to cut the capsicum. And for that first, I'm going to cut off this. I'll use a scissor. So once this is cut, I'm going to cut it into half, take out all the seeds, and even this portion, as you can see. I have removed this white portion. Now I'm going to take out all this excess seed. And I'm going to cut it very fine. And it should be very thin for sure. You see, I have cut this. If you want to leave it long like this, you could, but I'm gonna cut it into cubes because that's how most sautés are done. So you can see the fineness of the cutting. It should be very fine. And later on, I want, I could do a bit of this for it to be fine. And now I'm gonna cut my carrot. Everything has been separated. I'm gonna cut the carrot. The carrot has, I have boiled it a bit, but if you want, you could leave it. So now I'm going to cut it straight. It has become easy for me to cut because it has become boiled. And now I've cut the boiled one. Now you can see, it feels like I've seen different colors. For me, it looks like a flag with this in the center, right? Okay, so now I am going to check if my fish has been sauteed, marinated. Yes, I guess all my fish has been marinated, but I'll leave it there for 2 more minutes. So you can see, this is, and I can't just mash it like this, so I am going to peel it. So this is how it is on the inside. This is how the potato has become. It is very hot and soft. Now like this, you have to do all 3 of them. Smash it very nicely and fine so that you get a good mashed potato. Don't worry if this comes from the top because that's just the holes. So now all of it has come. So my potatoes, as you can see, the potatoes are being mashed. Just broken. So mash the potatoes nicely. So you can see the potatoes are mashed nicely. I'm going to turn it out so that the potatoes. So now I will add to this cat sprinkles, black pepper, and salt. So I'm going to put a little bit of salt and a bit of black pepper. As you can see, I have put this, and now I am going to mix it with my hands. It has to be mixed well, or else the potato wouldn't be mashed and taste good. So it has to be mixed.
now it is ready. As you can see, I have made a ball out of that. And I'm going to leave it aside. Now I'm going to take my fish, and I have seen that, and I'm going to fry it. My fish, marinated fish, is ready to fry. So now I'm going to take a pan, light it. Oops, 4 to 5 teaspoons of mustard oil. 1 teaspoon. 2 teaspoon. 3 and 4. I'm gonna put a little bit more. So I'm going to take So now I'm going to let it boil for some time and heat. Looks like the oil has been heated. So now I'm going to take my marinated fish and put it one by one into the pan. And then stir it between some time. While my fish So now I'm going to turn it. If you feel it is not ready to turn, then wait for some time. I think my fish are ready to turn. So I'm going to keep the gas on low flame for it to boil. And then while the fish is frying, I'm going to take another pan and do my vegetable saute. So all the vegetables I had cut are going to be used inside the saute. But before that, I am going to put a bit of oil. I'm going to use vegetable oil for the saute. This is vegetable oil. Here I have vegetable oil, and now I'm going to just put it. Here, so I put a little oil, and I'm going to wait for it to heat for some time. By the time, I'm going to check the fish and the fish. My good and yummy enough for it to be ready. So, my fish is in a good, very, very, very good condition. I am going to turn it now. So now again, I'm going to leave it for some time. So now my oil is heated, and I'm going to put in all the stuff. First, I'm going to put my spring onions. And keep instead of low flame. So this is, I'm going to put capsicum. And stir it there somewhere. And now with this, I'm going to have a fire open. Carrots. Doesn't it look colorful? And I will check our fish one more time. And now turning it again. I think the fish looks ready and done now. Can you see it? And now I'm going to put the gas off. And leave it out for some time. Now coming back to my saute. You can see. It looks like it's nicely done, but I'm gonna stir it for some more time. It is so delicious. Now it's done, so I'm gonna put the gas on. Looks like everything is ready. So let's see. My satay. But I think I can add a bit of mayo to it. It can give it more taste. So I will add a little bit of mayo. This looks nicely done. Now let's serve it. So I'm going to now you can see all these three recipes make this. So now this is ready to serve. Nice and hot to my mom. Happy Women's Day to all. Hope you all like the dish.